The clock is ticking for the South Korean military to replace its aging fleet of fighter jets, which have already reached or even exceeded their lifespans. Our Kim Hyun-bin looks into Korea's plans for making a smooth transition when replacing those jets.
The Korea fighter jet program aims to develop 4.5-generation fighter jets to fill in the gap with more advanced technology, as a batch of Korean fighters are set to be retired in the coming years.
South Korea's Air Force has around 400 jets in service, but roughly half of them are antiquated jets, such as the F-4 and F-5. These days, 4th and 5th generation fighters are the mainstay globally, but Korea is lagging behind with mostly 3rd generation jets.
Korea has set aside roughly $17 billion for a project to develop and mass-produce 124.5 generation fighter jets that will replace the Air Force's old F-4s and F-5s. The KFX jets are scheduled to be integrated into the Air Force in 2025. On top of that, Korea recently signed a roughly $7 billion U.S. deal with Lockheed Martin for 45th generation F-35 stealth fighters, though there are some concerns. Some experts worry that a delay could push Korea's already old fighter jet fleet to the limit. South Korea's defense ministry says it's looking into other options, such as enhancing the performance of the current KF-16 fleet and tanker aircraft to fill in temporarily. The KFX, however, will not be Korea's first homegrown fighter jet. The FA-50, which finished development in 2011, was integrated into the Air Force last October. That jet has already caught the eye of international buyers. Korea has exported more than 50 of them to Iraq, Indonesia, and the Philippines. Seoul also plans to sell 24 FA-50s to Peru this year in a deal worth some $2 billion U.S. Kim Hyun-bin, Arirang News.